I am online.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
I welcome you to this national webinar as a resource person. This is the session wherein we had started with grape and we'll be ending with your topic on another dollar earning fruit crop, that is pomegranate. Friends, sir, for the information, the webinar, of course, there are around 800 people who have registered from different parts of the country. It is showing around 200 are right now present. They are representing different parts of the country. For the information of the house, Dr. Supe was one of the person who has extensively worked on pomegranate. And I remember you, sir, when you were one of the resource person at Rahori Training Center. I remember that you are an excellent speaker and a very excellent resource person as far as pomegranate is concerned. I remember one instance that you mentioned that in one of the brainstorming sessions on pomegranate, which was chaired by Dr. Sharad Pawarji, he asked who is the person who is working on the ground on pomegranate. And Eng Vinay Supe sir stood and said that I am the person. So he was picked up for so many assignments on pomegranate. And today what you see, the scenario of pomegranate in Maharashtra, one of the great contributors is Dr. Vinay Supe. We are really privileged to have you on this webinar to speak, to share your experiences. And now I request Dr. Srinivas to please put up his resume before the house. Dr. Srinivas, please.
So good afternoon to everyone. So I think a warm welcome to the second session of our inaugural day of this particular national level webinar. And so I'm very happy that so it's a privilege to introduce a very famous personality, popular personality. So I've been very much associated with many crops, not only a pomegranate, but he is also associated with other crops again. So Dr. Vinay Supe, and so he has got a very excellent academic career. So apart from his career, so he has received various gold medals from his study period, particularly as a MSc, during his MSc. And after that again, so he has also very much associated with the various research activities again. And so he has got so many varieties in on his crown again. So that is a Phule Bhagwa Super and this Drudhula. And so these are the this pomegranate hybrid derivatives and pomegranate selections, particularly Bhagwa and Arakta. So he has been very much associated in release of these particular commercial varieties again. So apart from that, minor fruits, particularly this custard apple again, Phule Janaki and Phule Purandar. So he's the one who has been very much associated in developing these varieties again. So apart from that, again, fig varieties like this Phule Rajwadi, again, Red Gava, Phule Amrut, so tuberose even, apart from these fruit crops again, the flower crops, that is Phule Rajat. So like that, again, so many OP varieties again, that is tomato, chili and garlic. So a lot of the contribution is being made and so varieties has been released from this personality. And apart from that, again, she has also got so many technologies which are found to be very much useful to the farming community, and he could able to address various issues related to the commercial cultivation of the listed crop. And apart from that, again, so he has got very much association with the various organizations, particularly the Center of Excellence on Pomegranate under Indo-Israel work. So he has been very much closely associated with this particular program again. So apart from that again, so he has been very closely moving with the farming community, as Dr. Pravin Jogar mentioned about his reach to the farming community, and particularly through this even media training and even radio talks. And also, so he's the one, so presently holding the position of this ADRE but at Ganesh Kind Research Station. And I think every one of us knows about what is Ganesh Kind Research Station and its contribution towards this overall development of the particularly fruits. And it has changed the scenario of the fruit cultivation in, not only in Maharashtra, but over the different parts of the country through consumption or production in both way. So in this context again, so I felt very happy to introduce such a great personality. And I warmly welcome you, sir, for this particular program. So I think so your expertise will definitely enlighten us to go for addressing the various issues related to this pomegranate, sir. So over to you, sir, for our this presentation on this canopy management as well as crop regulation in pomegranate, sir.
Thank you. Good afternoon, all dignitaries present in this webinar, my dear scientists, dear friends, dear student friends, and some of the farmers are also there, it has been told. So let me call them, let me tell him the wish him the very good prospect for this pomegranate cultivation. And today the topic, my topic is canopy management and crop regulation in pomegranate. Actually, there is very little information available, scientific information available on this particular topic. But my experience, I have been working in this crop since last 27, 28 years. So there are some practical experiences in this particular canopy management and crop regulation also that we will share. Besides this canopy management, actually, when we talk about the canopy management of any crop, we mostly talk about the shoot management only, vegetative growth management. But in pomegranate, I have seen that not only shoot management, but the root management is also one of the part of this canopy management. So that also we will discuss in this particular topic. I have given this mobile number for the farming community. If they have some problems in this particular crop, they can contact me at any time and I can try to guide them. So coming to the topic, of canopy management and crop regulation in pomegranate, if you see the history of this pomegranate, actually this is not the indigenous crop to our nation. It has been migrated from Persia or Iran and cultivated extensively in Mediterranean countries like Spain, Morocco, Egypt, Iran, Afghanistan, and Balochistan. And to some extent in Burma, China, Japan, USA, Israel, Pakistan, and India. Now, India is playing a big role, a major role in this cultivation of this pomegranate nowadays, because of this development of the new varieties, blood red colored varieties. But the origin of this crop is Iran or Persia. Through Silk Road, it has migrated, or through evolution, it might have migrated to India. Today also, if you compare our pomegranate in Maharashtra, in Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, or Gujarat, or Rajasthan, if we compare this with the states with Himachal Pradesh or some part of Jammu, that is cold arid area, you will find the very distinguished morphological parameters are there. Our pomegranates are semi spreading.
Please mute others. Please mute. Otherwise, host, you can please mute them.
Our pomegranates are spreading types, semi spreading to spreading types, as compared to this Himachal. These types are erect growing. Then they are deciduous, ours evergreen, towards evergreen. They are acidic, our pomegranates are sweet in taste. They are hard seeded, our pomegranates are soft seeded. So there are morphological differences as well as biochemical differences are there in two types. So we have to develop our own technology actually, because our pomegranates are the unique pomegranate on the global scenario. So now, if you see the strength of pomegranate, you will see the required agroclimatic zones we have in all these states, mostly Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, and Gujarat, and then Rajasthan also. Then light to medium soil, this is the basic requirement of this crop, and we have light to medium soils also. Then availability of suitable varieties. Now the Bhagwa Super, now recently the NRC has developed one variety, Solapur Lal. So these are the suitable varieties for distant markets, and that is also one of the major strength for pomegranate cultivation. Then production around the year. If you see the scenario of global scenario, you will see that they can take only one bahar. After this snow is over, then they can take their bahar. But in our condition, we can take the production throughout the year. We Ambe Bahar, Muruga Bahar, or in Hasta Bahar also. In strong technical supports, we have universities, we are national centers, then even agriculture department is there. Then strong cooperative network among the farmers. In Maharashtra, we have Pomegranate Association, Growers Association. At national level, national level also, it is there. Then some farmers organizations are there, district-wise. Innovative farmers are there. Now we have seen in Karnataka also, there are very innovative farmers. Many times when I used to visit in Karnataka, I see that there are innovations in particularly in pomegranate. Then proximity to international airport and seaport. That is also one of our major strength. Now, coming to the national scenario, if you see this black line in between the semi-arid and arid belt, it starts from mostly Himachal Pradesh and ends in Tamil Nadu. In almost all states like Himachal Pradesh, then Haryana, part of Haryana, then Rajasthan, some part of Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. This is the belt where we can grow pomegranate very successfully, because in this particular area, the soils are very light and the climate is also suitable. These are the states, major states, where we are growing pomegranate now, today. Then these are some of the threats actually. And if you see the bacterial blight disease of pomegranate, the wilt is major issue in pomegranate. Non-adoption of improved agro techniques, that is also one of the threat. Then quality planting material, that is another this one. Exogenous use of fertilizer, this is very important. Exogenous use of fertilizers and water, this is very important threat actually. We have to analyze the soil before application of fertilizers. And water also, I have included the water management in this particular topic today. Though it doesn't concern with canopy management, but it is a part of resistance mechanism. So that's why I have included that presentation also. Then lack of soil-based nutrition management. Definitely we should analyze the soil and then we should decide how to manage the nutrients. Heavy incidence of fungal diseases. Heavy infestation of nematodes and other pests. Lack of processing and preservation facilities are not there. Then domestic marketing and export is also one of the important threat. Now, basically, if you see, many times we compare this pomegranate with grapes. Many farmers, they have grapes also. Afterwards, they have planted pomegranate also. So they are looking this towards this pomegranate through the specs of grapes. But that is not feasible actually, because grape is a vine crop. Pomegranate, it is a hardy xerophyte crop. The physiology of both the crops is very unique and distant. So that's why it's not proper to manage the pomegranate crop just like a grape. The xerophytes plant has its own adaptive strategies, and that have been mentioned here, the glossy surface on leaves, fatty acids. That's why the transpiration is very less through leaves because of this glossy appearance. Then thick cuticle, covering of epidermis of leaves. That is also one of the unique adaptive strategy. Leaf area is very small. Very small leaves are there. In grapes, the leaf size is very big. Leaf area is very big. But in pomegranate, the leaves are very small. Then sunken stromata on dorsal side of the leaves. That is also a unique adaptive strategy of pomegranate. Sunken stromata, less number of stromata. Being it has the less number of stromata and sunken stromata, again the transpiration and all those aspects will be less in this particular crop. That's why the water management is very important in pomegranate because of these adaptive strategies. Then opening and closing of stromata in desired temperature. This is also one of the most important adaptive strategy in pomegranate. Mostly the opening and closing of stromata, it continues up to 11 a.m. in summer season, and it again starts after 4:50 or 5 p.m. to some 1 or 2 hours in particular pomegranate. That's why whenever you are applying the irrigation, or whenever you are applying the systemic fungicides or insecticides or any nutrition through foliar application, we have to apply it before 11 a.m. That is one of the important aspect to manage the resistance of this particular crop. Then two important management areas for quality fruits are proper canopy, then fruit zone management. Now, after all, we are doing all this business for the quality fruits, not the quantity fruits. The quantity, if you think of the only quantity of fruits, then there is no need to see any more. We are not to concentrate more on this aspect actually. But in the market actually, we need quality fruits. And for to get the quality fruits, we have to see or to have to study all those aspects like rhizosphere management. Root system and rhizosphere management is very important in pomegranate cultivation. Then dormancy of plant. For bud development also, CN ratio, the carbohydrate-nitrogen ratio, plays a very important role. Carbohydrate accumulation is mostly in the dormancy period of the plant. And that's why the CN ratio, maintenance of the CN ratio, we have to maintain it in the dormancy period. So that is also one of the important aspect. Photosynthesis. In the morning, Dr. Vasudeva has explained this photosynthetic, this one, aspects. So that is very important in pomegranate also. Then environmental effects like temperature, wind, then rainfall, light, everything has very great role in quality production. Irrigation management, particularly being a shallow root system in pomegranate and xerophyte nature, the irrigation plays a very important role in pomegranate cultivation and for the quality fruit production. Then female flowers and fruit set. There are two types of majorly flowers comes in pomegranate. One is male flower and another is female flower. Hermaphrodite and intermediary. There are two types again in flower, female flower. But the more number of female flowers we expect actually for better fruit set and for better yields. So that female flowers, when it comes, when the CN ratio is maintained in the fruiting cane, then and then only you will get the female flowers. So the role of carbohydrate nitrogen ratio is also very important to have a female, more number of female flowers. Then nutrition. The nutrition may be through soil or maybe through foliar application. It has a great importance for quality production. Environmental factors that play vital role in quality fruit production. The major is temperature. If summer also, summer in the morning session also, one of our PhD student has asked about the sun scorching in mango. When we go for open center, what about the scorching, fruit scorching? So definitely in pomegranate also, this problem exists, but it is mostly in summer, this one, bahar, that is ambia bahar. Then wind velocity. The more wind velocity is not acceptable, because in more wind velocity, the honeybee activity is not there. At the time of pollination, we should have some less actually wind velocity. Then light, first layer of canopy that absorbs almost all lights and affects the bud development, fruit color, soluble sugars, acid levels and phenol levels. But the inner side of the canopy is not getting the light at a proper stage. So that's why we have to go for open center training system, and that we will see afterwards. Then the water, seasonal effects, soil type, it depends on the soil type also, and the hydrogen oxygen balance in the soil. So that's why we have to irrigate pomegranate, not daily actually, or not an alternate day, but we should irrigate the pomegranate at Vapsa condition. The agriculture persons, they note the Vapsa condition very well. Coming to the definition of canopy management, it is a series of operations on the above ground portion of the plant, aiming towards maximized production of quality fruits per unit canopy area. This is the definition actually. And the second meaning is also canopy management deals with the development and maintenance of the plant structure in relation to the size and shape for maximum yield and quality. Our ultimate aim is maximum yield and quality production. But to me, actually, if you see the total canopy, not only vegetative canopy, but if you see the the underlined portion, that is above ground portion. So I have some reservations for the above ground portion, in particularly in pomegranate. It should be below ground portion also. The rhizosphere, the root development, that has also a great importance in the canopy management of the above portion. If the rhizosphere, the development of rhizosphere is proper, then your canopy will be better. And if the roots are not there, definitely your shoot management will not be proper. So the canopy management, in particular in pomegranate, includes above ground portion as well as below ground portion. And in all, if you see the canopy management, in particular in pomegranate, that is training plus pruning of shoots and roots. Roots also are being included in this particular canopy management. Then these are the some of the principles of canopy management. Optimize sunlight interception and penetration. In the morning session also, our both speakers, Dr. Vasudeva and Dr. Mango, Dr. Walmohan, they have given a emphasis on this sunlight interception, and that is really one of the important aspect to have optimized sunlight in the canopy. So likewise, we have to manage the canopy. Then facilitating conversion of sunlight into chemical energy by leaf, plant leaf. So the canopy should be there. Canopy should, like, in a such a way that your most of the leaves should face the sunlight or sun rays, so that the transpiration of the photosynthetic activity will be more in this, and every leaf will be a functional leaf. Then facilitating aeration inside the canopy. I have some photographs to show you. In that, actually, we will discuss this aeration also. Then control plant structure, including structure. This is also one of the important principle. Avoidance of microclimate congenial for disease and pest management. If you manage the canopy with as open center and the ground portion open, then you will see that there is no dearth of any microclimate development for congenial disease development. Then rejuvenate tree health and productivity. Definitely, if the gardens are old, then we have to rejuvenate it for their health and productivity. Improve efficiency of spraying and harvesting. This canopy management improves efficiency of spraying as well as harvesting also. It maintains consistent cropping. In pomegranate also, there is a problem actually. When we harvest one crop, in the second crop, we are getting some problems of female flower induction. So that can be managed through this canopy management. Then improved fruit color, quality and yield. After all, we are doing all this business for quality fruit production. So that can be achieved through a better quality yield. Then convenience in carrying the cultural operations. That is also one of the important principle. And economy in obtaining the required canopy architecture. Definitely, if you manage the canopy, your major expenses is on pesticides application, and that will be minimized. Then considerations for canopy management. The plants respond differently in different environment. That is also an important consideration. So likewise, according to the season, we have to modify the canopy management. If we are taking the bahar in summer season, then we have to increase the canopy. If you are taking the in Mruga Bahar, that is in June, July, or up to September, October, then you have to minimize the canopy. It depends on the climatic conditions or the season or the environment. Then development of shoot and root system in the plant has symbiotic relationship. If the roots are more, definitely the shoots will be the more. So we must concentrate on root development rather than shoot development, in particularly in pomegranate. Weak crotches in the branches and direction of the branches can be corrected by unequal cuttings. So weak crotches, it's not desirable actually. So we have to maintain the proper crotches also in canopy management. Then vegetative growth and fruiting yield have antagonistic effect. If the vegetative growth is more, the fruiting yield will be minimum. So we have to manage this vegetative and reproductive stage. We have to balance it while doing this canopy management business. Apical dominance is a natural phenomena, and that plays a very important role in induction of flowering, particularly in pomegranate. For that, we have to break this apical dominance when we are going for canopy management. Vigor of shoots varies inversely with number of crop load. That is also one of the important consideration. Fruit quality is affected by heavy cropping. We don't recommend heavy cropping in pomegranate, as the market is for only better quality A grade quality or B grade quality fruits. That's why we monitor the number of fruits on the plant, and that's why this heavy cropping is not desirable or it is not acceptable in pomegranate. Then pruning effects are localized. Definitely it is localized and environmental based also. So we have to modify these pruning technologies according to the season also. Then young shoots give the best material for blossom bud formation. That's why we have to maintain the young shoots. Young shoots are very important in this blossom bud formation. So we have to maintain, but we have to go for a clipping of the apical portion to stop the flow and to stop the apical dominance. Then removal of shoot results in loss of accumulated carbohydrates. The 1 year old branch or 6 month old branch, we should not cut that branch because it gives the losses of accumulation. Gives losses of carbohydrates accumulation. So that is also one of important aspect while going for pruning. That's why we recommend only light pruning instead of the heavy pruning in pomegranate. Then beneficial effect of canopy management. Strong framework for primary branches is very much needed. When we start growing, that we will see afterwards, but when we start growing the new plant, we have to monitor its training system, like in a single stem system or multi-stem system. And strong framework for up to 2 years, we have to maintain this framework afterwards. Then wider crotches in scaffold branches is also important aspect, and that how these wider crotches will be maintained, that we will see afterwards. Then healthy and well distributed secondary and tertiary branches. These are the fruiting canes. The secondary and tertiary branches are the fruiting canes. So that's why the fruiting canes should be healthy. It should have accumulated the carbohydrates properly for a proper CN ratio maintenance and for female flower induction. So we have to maintain those tertiary and secondary branches very healthy. Then sufficient fruiting terminals in most productive areas. That is also one of the beneficial effect. Healthy foliage with high photosynthetic efficiency to maximum the solar radiation use efficiency. It's one of the most important beneficial effect of canopy management. Healthy foliage leads to maximum carbohydrates accumulation, and maximum carbohydrates accumulation leads to better female and male flowers ratio in the fruiting cane. So that's why heavy foliage is one of the important beneficial effect. Enough space for air circulation inside the canopy. The canopy should be very free inside the tree. It should not be dense, and even the light doesn't penetrate up to the inner leaves or inner branches. So that's why it is better to prune those branches and make the plant very free inside. Then objectives of this canopy management: to restore root and shoot ratio. We have already seen that it has some positive relationship root and shoot development. So we have to restore this root and shoot ratio, prevent formation of weak crotches, to develop specific geometry within the plant and its overall topography, to maintain optimum balance between vegetative and reproductive part. That is also one of the important objective. Regulate the number and position of main scaffold branch. As usually we used to maintain 4 branches at 4 directions, but we have to manage it and regulate it. Then remove crisscross branches. at the time of pruning, when we after vegetative phase, when we used to take the crop in the reproductive stage after 2 years, then at that time we should remove all those crisscross branches and the interfering branches, because these crisscross branches are not the fruiting canes. They unnecessarily take your food and disturb the resistance mechanism in the plant body. That's why instead of maintaining those branches, we should remove those branches. Remove water shoots and suckers also. Suckers is a regular phenomenon in pomegranate. It comes up to 2 years mostly, and we have to remove it timely. After 1 or 2 months, we have to remove. Then water shoots also is like this. The internal, if there are presence of water shoots in the internal canopy, then in that canopy actually we should remove those water shoots from the base. But if it is in outside the canopy, then we have to maintain these water shoots for next year's fruiting cane. Then regulate growth, vigor and direction of shoot. That is also important for photosynthetic activity. Regulate optimum bearing. That is important because pomegranate has a regular flowering behavior, and regularly the flower comes in bunches in phases actually. So after getting a proper fruit load on the crop, we have to remove this bearing, these flowers. Then regulate exposure to sunlight or otherwise. This is important for sunlight, for photosynthetic activity. Then facilitate the orchard operations. This is also one of the important aspect. Then if you see the inherent plant characteristics for a plant canopy, plant nature, we have already seen that this pomegranate in our area particularly, it is a semi-spreading or spreading type behavior, the plant nature. It is not erect one. In the foreign countries, you will see that the plant structure is erect one. But in our area in particular, it is a spreading type. Then bearing behavior also, it is in flush, very number of flushes it comes. Then the flowers are also two types of majorly flowers, male and female flower. Then flushing pattern, if you see, the flushing pattern is also, it is a continuous process in pomegranate after start of bahar. Then action of growth hormones in the apical portion, when the new shoots comes in the apical portion, the maximum auxins are there. The shoots are mostly red in color, and the percentage of auxins is more in this red tip shoots. That's why we have to monitor all those red tip shoots, so that the while translocation or the ascent of sap, you will find the nutrition flow will stop at the tip and it will be diverted to the sub branches. Then dormancy pattern. The dormancy comes after completion of bahar, after harvesting. But we have to maintain this dormancy. We have to give some fertilizer application, irrigation also, to accumulate the carbohydrates. And then we have to send it, the crop in dormancy for one or 2 months. It depends on the soil condition. So we have to study this dormancy pattern also. Then influence of environment on architecture. Definitely, there is a very great role of environment in canopy architecture is there. We have already discussed that in summer, we have to monitor it in other way. In rainy season, we have to monitor in other way. Then set of conditions and resources for canopy management in pomegranate. The main thing is planting system. Nowadays, the farmers are very planting this pomegranate at very closer spacing, 13 by 7 feet. Some are in Maharashtra, one of our great farmer has planted it as 6 by 6 feet. So this is not actually feasible. This is not practicable to plant this in very high density plantation. The spacing what we recommended, that is 15 by 10 feet, 15 feet in row to row and 10 feet in plant to plant. It depends on the soil condition actually. If the soils are very light, then you can go below up to 13 feet. And in case of plant to plant, you can go below up to 9 feet only, 13 by 9, but not below by 13 by 9. So that should be your spacing at least. Then solar radiation, this is most important condition. And if we are lucky that we are getting very proper solar radiation throughout the year in our areas. Then wind velocity, that doesn't play a big role, but still it has some role in pollinating phases. Rainfall pattern, it is also one of the important aspect, particularly in Mrugabaha, because at the time of flowering season, at the time of induction of flowers, the pollination is mostly done by the honeybees. Honeybee activity should be there. But if the heavy rainfall is there, or a continuous rainfall is there, or even the cloudy nature is there, the honeybee activity will be stopped. And your all inducted flowers will drop. So at that time, we have to see that the rainfall, according to the rainfall pattern, we have to monitor our bahar. Then the light distribution, definitely the morning light, evening light, and for anthocyanin development, the light color, the red color in the light, it is also very great importance for anthocyanin development at the time of maturity of the fruits, physiological maturity of the fruits. Then flushing pattern, if you see, there are male to female flowers ratio 60 to 40, 70 to 30 in this particular in the range. Male flowers are more and female flowers are comparatively less. But that is the natural ratio actually, and we have to maintain this ratio. Then first flush, male flowers comes, then mostly perfect flowers, that is female flowers. Period of full bloom lasts about 1 month. Or it may continue in the heavy soils up to 2 months also. Then flowering and fruit state occurs in about 3 to 4 distinct waves. And that's why we cannot harvest this crop at once. We have to harvest it in 2 to 3 harvestings. Then flowering in Mediterranean countries between March, April and July, August continues up to 10 to 12 weeks. So that we will not consider of this aspect which because we are thinking about in our area only. Then these are the types of flowering and fruiting habits. Indian type, evergreen, mostly evergreen. Exotic types are deciduous types. Then flowers are born on current and past seasons growth, solitary or in cluster. So we have to maintain this current season growth also, and we have to maintain, monitor this past season growth also for induction of flowering. We cannot cut the current season growth completely. We have to monitor it accordingly so that we will get maximum female flowers. Then sex expression influenced by season. This also is one of the important habit, but it depends mainly on the natural resources or environment. So, but that doesn't have a big problem in pomegranate. Hermaphrodite flowers give higher fruit set, and cross pollination is the must in pomegranate, because 97% pollination it is through honeybees only. So we have to
Sorry to interrupt you, sir. Slides are not moving.
Not moving?
Yes, sir. The last slide is on a set of conditions and resources for canopy management.
Okay.
That has remained static.
So can I stop this and I can start once again?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes.
Lecture, sir. Now, are you getting this slide?
Yes, sir, it is moving.
Okay. So, can I repeat it, this one?
Yes, sir.
So, these are the actually fruiting habits in pomegranate national Indian condition, and the exotic types also. Mostly the Indian types are evergreen type. Except the Himachal cultivation or the Jammu, some cold arid area. In the rest of the India, it is evergreen type, mostly evergreen type. Then the flowers born on current and past seasons growth. That's why we have to maintain this current season growth also for better fruiting, where flowering. Then sex expression influenced by season, that is the natural this one, but still there is that is not the big problem of sex expressions. Then hermaphrodite flowers give higher fruit set. There are two types of hermaphrodite flowers in pomegranate. One is hermaphrodite and another is intermediary flower. It has some exudate stigma. Then cross pollination is one of the important habit in pomegranate, because 97% of cross pollination is through honeybee. So at the time of flowering, in that particular phase, we have to maintain this honeybee and we have to avoid this application of pesticides at that particular time. Instead, we can go for biological sprays like metrazum, bivaria, or verticillium. So these are the two types actually, male and female. Male flowers, the male role of male flowers is pollination only, and the female flower goes for fruits. Spacing, this is our recommended spacing, 4.5 meter by 3 meters. So that is our recommended spacing. In Maharashtra, we are recommended it. But in even Karnataka and Andhra also, the same spacing has given a better results. And as earlier we have discussed that we can minimize the spacing up to 13 by 9 feet. That is 4 by 2.5 meters at the most, not below that. Then points to be noted for canopy, important points to be noted for canopy management. The tree grows continuously. Hence, canopy designing should be done from the initial years of the planting system, planting itself. In the initial years, while doing this canopy management business, we have to give emphasis on training mostly instead of pruning. We have to maintain the main stem, the primary branches, the secondary and tertiary branches. So this is a continuous job up to 2 years. And after that 2 years, then pruning actually starts. The structure and the shape of the canopy is maintained by regular management practices. This is a regular practice up to 2 years where to manage this canopy. The canopy management is a continuous process throughout the life of the pomegranate. But for training system, it is up to 2 years mostly. Training is a physical technique that controls the shape, size, and direction of the tree growth in early stages of tree establishment. Up to 2 years, we have to maintain this. Then open center training system is followed in pomegranate mostly, because the sunlight interception is more in open center training system. Fruitful and differentiated buds are located at distant portion of the branches. That's why all those branches or all those leaves should be exposed to the sunlight mostly. Likewise, we have to modify the canopy. Besides this canopy, we must give emphasis on soil health also. Soil health, definitely, if the soil health is better, then plant health will be definitely better. So we must give more emphasis on soil health. Soil health, whatever I have seen in soil health, that we should avoid adding pesticides, fungicides, or the chemicals in the soil. Because the microbial activity, what is going on in the soil, for chelation of nutrition, for conversion of nutrition, for availability of nutrition, it totally stops after the application of these fungicides or the chemicals in the soil. So instead, if we have to maintain the soil health, we should avoid this fungicidal application in the soil. Fungicides are mostly for spraying purposes on the plants, on the leaves or on the fruits. It is not recommended on any bottle of fungicide to drench this fungicide in the soil. But still we are drenching, I don't know why. But it has a very adverse effect on the plant health. If you apply this fungicide in the soil, it has adverse effect on the plant health also. So avoid this fungicidal application in soil.
The slides are stuck again.
Again. Are you getting now?
Yeah, it's moving, but I think we thought you're on the next slide.
So instead, I will not this one slideshow. Now you are you seeing?
Yeah, we can see.
Huh? Okay, I will keep like this one only. So this major emphasis should be on soil health, and then after automatically the plant health will be better. So instead of application of this fungicide, we should apply some organic manure, organic compost, or even bacterial consortia, some bacteria in the soil, or even some leaves, the extract of leaves, natural products all we can apply in the soil. That gives a better results for microbial activity. So that is one of the important aspect for canopy management also. Though it is comes under the soil, but I believe, I personally believe that if you see, if you give more emphasis on soil, you will have not, you don't have to worry about the plant health. So in that context, the I am particularly now working on the soil health in this Pune, my in my office, or in Pomegranate also among the farmers. Then rhizosphere management, it is also one of the important, very important aspect in as regards the canopy management of the crop. Because canopy, initially I also told you that canopy is not to manage the, to monitor the shoots only, to monitor the roots also, to monitor the activity, root activity also. It is also one of the part of the canopy management. So rhizosphere management is also one of the important aspect, so that your chelation and all those processes, formation of organic acids, then amino acids, sugars, everything will be better if the microbial count is better in your soil. Then photosynthesis. In the morning session, Dr. Vasudeva has given a very descriptive lecture on this photosynthesis. So there is no need to explain this slide actually, but photosynthesis plays a very big role in pomegranate for carbohydrate accumulation mostly. Then these two aspects that I have seen in pomegranate as regards the canopy management and the resistance mechanism of the plant is ascent of sap and translocation. These are the two physiological processes. I am not a physiologist, I am a horticulturist, but still a few things that what I observed that I am going to share with you, that if these two phenomena, upward movement of water and minerals from the root to the crown through xylem, that is upward movement, that is ascent of sap, and the translocation, that is the downward movement of sugars or carbohydrates from the leaves to the non-photosynthetic parts like stem or roots. So this flow, these two flows are proper in the plant body. You did not want to worry about any physiological process in pomegranate, what I have seen. If the porosity of soil is excellent, then the soil, the hydrogen and water, hydrogen and oxygen balance will be proper in the soil. And in that particular case, you will find there's this ascent of sap and translocation, these two phenomena works very better. So that's why more emphasis should be given on the porosity of the soil. And that's why the WAFSA condition irrigation is must. So on the basis of the irrigation, on the basis of WAFSA condition, we should irrigate the plant. How to irrigate the plant, that is another aspect that we will see afterwards. Then one thing is there in pomegranate, the many farmers, they are unnecessarily spraying ethrel or some thiourea or some chemicals to defoliate the plant. But if physiologically, if you see that it has been mentioned in the yellow box, that leaves are sink when they are young and become source later when they are matured. When the leaves are matured, they used to give some carbohydrates accumulation to the plant. And at that time, we are defoliating those leaves. So that is, that breaks your resistance. And again, we are creating new leaves on the plant, which are the sinks. They will take the nutrition from the plant body. They are not going to help you for another for the further carbohydrate accumulation. So the young leaves should be there, but the older leaves, the mature leaves, should be maintained instead of dropping those leaves. That is also one of the mechanism for canopy management and resistance mechanism in pomegranate. This is the training system. Two types of training systems are there in pomegranate: single stem system and multi-stem system. This is multi-stem system. Both the systems have their own advantages and their own disadvantages also. In the single stem system, if you have some soil-borne problems like root rotting, nematodes, stem borer, short hole borer, or any other problems like calcium content, calcium carbonate content is more in your soil, then instead of single stem system, you should go for multi-stem. In the single stem, if you are maintaining the single stem system, then heading back of the apical shoot is done at 70 centimeters. Then during first year growth, 4 to 6 shoots are maintained. Mostly we use, we maintain 4 shoots, not 6 shoots. But 4 shoots at 4 directions we are going to maintain to form the scaffold limbs to produce secondary and tertiary branches. Main stem is kept free without any branches up to 70 centimeters. No branch, there are continuous induction of branches up to 70 centimeters also, but we have to remove those branches, we have to remove the suckers also continuously. Then pomegranate has tendency to put forth many suckers and we need to remove regularly from planting onwards. It is a continuous process and that may continue up to 2 years. Then removal of ground suckers, water shoots, crisscross branches, dead and diseased branches, that is a type of training. This is multi-stem system. If you have some problems like this shuttle borer and stem borer or nematodes, then soil problems are there, rotting over it. So then in this case, instead of single stem, you can go for multi-stem system. Or you are, if you are maintaining this orchard on the Y system, Y training system, then you have to go for multi-stem instead of single stem. So multi-stem has also its own own advantage. Like it automatically, it becomes an open center training system. The four branches, four main stems are grown at four directions. That's why the center remains open. Naturally, it remains open. In single stem system, we have to open the center. But in this multi-stem system, that it occurs naturally. In multi-stem system, we maintain 3 to 4 stems, mostly 4 stems at 4 directions also. Then apical shoots are allowed to grow up to 1 meter. Then train the main shoots in each direction. Allowed to grow up to 1 meter or 120 centimeter and then pinch the apical bud. All the main stems are kept free without any branch. Main stems are kept free. Pomegranate has tendency to put for many suckers and this we have to remove. That is a continuous process. Then the removal of fruitful and differentiated bud located at the distance portion of the branches. That is also after, you'll find that after 8 months of planting or after 10 months of planting, you will get the flowering. Male flowers and female flowers used to come. Then we have to maintain those, we have to remove those flowers continuously up to 2 years, up to first bahar. Then these are some of the papers that effect of training system in pomegranate. And if you see the multi-stem, that is three stem, four stem, or even 5 stem, it has given maximum yield than one stem, single stem. This is also the same experiment at Aruppukottai in Tamil Nadu. Then this is the comparison between single stem and multi-stem. This type of canopy management should be there. The below portion from soil up to the plant should have a height of 2 feet at least and up to 2.5 feet. Then for each main primary branch, you have to again remove the shoots up to 1.5 feet. And then afterwards, you have to maintain the canopy of the plant. So that the center, the open center from above portion also and the center portion from below portion also, it will remain free for aeration and sunlight and everything. So such type of plant, this canopy management should be there. Then in this particular aspect, you will see that the sunlight between 11 to 4, it can incorporate in the plant body and that may control the diseases and pest also. That may help to control the incidence of diseases and pest also. And even the photosynthetic activity also. Then this is the picture from my Indo-Israel work plan. We had some Indo-Israel work plan project, pomegranate, at 4 locations at national level. One was at Rahuri, one was at Bagalkot, and one is in Haryana, and fourth one is in Rajasthan, Bassi. So the four projects, I was the cluster head for these four projects. But I could see that some recommendations or some results, very fantastic results, we got in this particular project. And one of them is the canopy management. You can see the canopy management of this particular plant or this orchard. You will find that every plant has a height of at least 2 feet. क्या नहीं हो रहा है? हेलो
सर, प्लीज गो अहेड, प्लीज गो अहेड.
सो यू कैन सी हियर द हाइट ऑफ प्लांट, इट इज फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड लेवल इट इज 2 feet और 2.5 feet. सो दैट हैज एडेड एडवांटेज दैट इन द केस ऑफ बैक्टीरियल ब्लाइट डिजीज, इफ द इनोक्युलेशन इज ऑन द ग्राउंड इट विल नॉट रीच इन द नेक्स्ट सीजन इन द प्लांट बॉडी. So that much distance we maintained in that particular canopy management. This is the 16 months plant. You can't believe that this is a 16 month plant, but this is the 16 months only 16 months plant or orchard. And you can see the canopy and leaf area of this plant. No disease. Every time we are spraying at the interval of 15 days, not less than 15 days. Plus, when we observed the disease incidence in this particular orchard, there were no diseases. The diseases were up to percentage of 10% to the tune of 10% only, but not more than that. So that is the fantasy of this particular canopy management. And the main thing is that in this orchard, instead of canopy management above the ground, we manage the canopy below the ground, the root canopy we maintain. And that has given the better results above the soil portion. Now you can see the inner portion of the plant. It is totally free. We used to maintain this free canopy underneath the canopy to have a better aeration, so that there is a great scope for development of big size fruits in this particular maintenance of canopy. Then while going for pruning is also a part of canopy management. Light pruning is mostly recommended. In our experiments at Rahuri, we conducted some ICR experiments in Rahuri, and we could come out with some recommendations like light pruning up to the tune of 20 centimeters from the apical portion. So that is our recommendation, from apical portion up to 20 centimeters, not more than 20 centimeters pruning. So that is light pruning actually. In that particular pruning system, pruning style, we will find that we are not cutting any matured fruiting branch. Only the new shoots, the immature shoots, we are cutting it. And if you see the female to male ratio or male to female ratio in this particular type of pruning system, for 60-40 male female ratio, we can maintain the 60-40 female ratio in this particular type of pruning system. But if you go for heavy pruning or the drastic pruning, you will find either there will be only male flowers or either there will be only shoots, but no female flower you will find. So instead of that, what the recommendations or the results have shown, that light pruning has given a very important results, and that's why we should follow this this light pruning. In this particular picture, you can see the canopy is a very free canopy. You can see the aeration and for sunlight, every branch will get the sunlight and aeration. Likewise, we have to free all the branches. Then why pruning is necessary? Intention, definitely to stop the apical dominance. That is one of the important aspects for pruning. So apical dominance means to stop the upper tip, the growing tip. And that should be not more than 20 centimeters. The intensity of pruning, no drastic pruning, only light pruning. Time of pruning, so this is after when the natural defoliation starts in pomegranate. When we keep this garden in the dormancy, after 2 months or after 2.5 months, you will find that there is a natural leaf fall. At that time, we have to go for pruning. So that indicates, the natural leaf fall indicates that the fruiting cane has proper carbohydrate accumulation, proper CN ratio is maintained in the plant body, and that's where the leaves are defoliated naturally. At that time, we should have a light pruning and we should start the new bahar. Pruning, what is the importance of pruning? All we know that it breaks the apical dominance, that is the important this one. Then pruning of terminal portion lowers the flowering, helps for better fruit quality afterwards. Then all advantages are there, pruning, but of light pruning only. So this was our intensity of pruning experiment, and you will see the induction of female flower at 20 centimeter pruning. This should be the canopy of the plant, and the fruit should be underneath the canopy of the, it should not be exposed to the sunlight, particularly in summer bahar or even in winter bahar also. So that will give a better color and size. So this is also one of the important aspects for canopy management also. Because what I personally observed that the maintenance of rhizosphere along with the water management gives a better canopy of the plant. So that's why I have included this water management topic also in this particular aspect. Need of water, everyone knows that everybody needs water for their survival. But the water requirement of the crop, it depends on the intensity of the sunlight, temperature, humidity, wind velocity, and soil evaporation, transpiration, everything is depends on the quantity of water to be given. But still, if you see the present status on the farmer's field, you will find that they put only one lateral and that two drippers inside the canopy of the plant. You can see the drippers by two sides of stem, but both the drippers are inside the canopy. That's why whatever irrigation we are giving here, you will find the wetting zone, it affects your main stem also. And you are irrigating to the supporting roots. You are not irrigating to the feeding roots. So that is the disadvantages of this irrigation system. And the further one is, whatever irrigation we are giving, whatever water we are giving, because of the shadow of this canopy, it is not being evaporated properly. And next day again, we are adding the water. And next day again, we are adding the water. We are going on adding the water, and that actually creates some problems like dieback or even breaking in the resistance of the plant. So instead of this lateral system, if we go, instead of the dripper inside the dripper system, if we put this dripper outside the canopy, this is the proper method. You remove this dripper from this side and put it outside the canopy. That is the only technique behind this irrigation. You will find that you are giving irrigations to the feeding roots. You are not giving irrigations to the supporting roots. These are the supporting roots. This is the main stem. This is unnecessarily affected through this nematodes and all fungal issues. So in this particular system, you can find that if you irrigate the plant outside the canopy, you will see that you are giving irrigation to the feeding roots only. Then the natural evaporation process will occur in this particular case. When the sunlight comes to this particular place, the irrigation given is evaporated properly. And that's why the oxygen and hydrogen balance will be maintained in the soil. And that will enhance the microbial activity also. Instead of single lateral, you can have a double lateral system also. In Indo-Israel projects, I have seen that instead of single lateral, the double lateral system plays a very important role in development of canopy or in development of plant resistance. So likewise, this is the picture that again I brought it, because in this particular soil, you can see this is the calcareous soil. The soil is containing about 22% of calcium carbonate, and nobody will recommend cultivation of pomegranate in this particular soil. But still, we took this crop in this challenge, and we could succeed properly. And we saw that if we monitor the irrigation system, you will see that resistance mechanism plays an important role in this particular pomegranate, because it is a shallow rooted crop. It is not a deep-rooted crop. Tap-rooted crop is not. This is a spreading roots are there. Then shallow roots are there. So that's why it gives a better results in irrigation system. So what we did actually initially, when this plant was planted, both the laterals were beside this one. One was either in this direction and another was in another direction. And as soon as the crop started growing, after 3 months or 4 months, we have moved these laterals outside the canopy. So from stem away to away. Now you can see the difference between stem and the lateral. And you can further see the root system. The root system is underneath the canopy, underneath the lateral. So number of roots are, you can see here, the number of roots are there. So this actually brings the resistance in the plant. And this is, I think, the one of the most important canopy management in particularly in pomegranate, instead of the topmost above shoot management. In this particular irrigation system, we were irrigating this orchard only 2 times a week, on Monday and on Tuesday, Thursday, on Monday and on Thursday. And that to be up to only half an hour, 30 minutes irrigation. That was managed through up to 16 months, only 30 minutes irrigation on Monday and 30 minutes irrigation on Thursday. So you can see the minimum irrigation, whatever we required, we have seen the adaptive strategies of this crop. That itself shows that this crop requires a very less quantity of water for physiological processes. And that we have seen that in this particular trial, that with minimum irrigation, you can see the canopy and structure of the plant. The second important thing you can see in this orchard, we have not used some bamboos or some staking material to stake the plant, to give the shape to the plant. The plant is standing on its own. That is the fantasy of this canopy management or the root management. So that is an important aspect. So this is that orchard. You will not see anywhere the bamboo or the staking material. Then the another topic is seasons, crop regulation. Crop regulation, it includes actually two things. The one is season and the bahar management. The two aspects I have taken in this particular presentation. So mostly there are three seasons, Ambiya Bahar, Muruga Bahar and Hasta Bahar. And we all know that Ambiya Bahar starts in January. Muruga starts in Muruga Nakshatra, that is June onwards. Then Hasta Nakshatra starts in Hasta Nakshatra and it ends in March or May. But overall, if you see overall picture of these three seasons, the Ambiya Bahar is better as compared to the other bahars, because the disease incidence of diseases faced and even the quality of the fruits is, and even the economical, if you see the economics of the particular growing economics, the minimum expenditure is on Ambiya Bahar. That's why Ambiya Bahar is better than rest of the bahar. But after all, the bahar selection of bahar, it depends on the market, what the farmer getting the market, according to he has to modify his bahar. So all the three bahars have their advantages and disadvantages also. In Hasta Bahar, when the crop comes in March, April, May, at that time the sunlight intensity is more, the temperatures are more. That's why anthocyanin pigment doesn't develop in the fruits. And that's why the color, the required color, you will not get the proper color to the fruits. Bahar management in regulation of crop regulation is one of the important aspects for carbohydrates accumulation or CN ratio maintenance. This bahar management is important. What we do with this in this bahar regulation, that we take only one bahar out of these three bahars. In these three bahars, we can monitor these three bahars also, plus minus. We can extend this Ambiya Bahar up to March, or we can prepone the Ambiya Bahar in December also. It depends on the climatic conditions. Likewise, it's in Muruga and Hasta Bahar also. But when you are going to take the bahar, you should take only one bahar instead of the three. Only one bahar will give you the best management or best results. So depending on the marketable market, you can choose your bahar, and only one bahar you have to take. Then fruit quality of ambia that we have seen, then withholding of water for 30 to 40 days, then light in light soils, and withholding of water up to 45 days in medium soils, that is recommended. But it depends actually farmer to farmer, it will differ, because every farmer has his own environmental conditions or the soil conditions. So he has to see the period of withholding. He has to monitor, or he has to observe the withholding of water, and the indication is that natural leaf fall. When the natural leaf fall starts, and when it goes up to the tune of 30%, then at that time you should start your new bahar. Root pruning through cultural practices. This is also one of the important aspects that we will see. Light pruning that we have already seen, and application of organic manures to increase the organic carbon in the soil. Then bahar treatment, just after completion of harvesting, apply the major nutrients like NPK at 1:2.5:2.5 in this ratio. But it will definitely, the quantity of the fertilizer will depend on the soil status. And on that status we will, and the age of the plant, the soil conditions, everything. Then apply water continuously up to 30 days. After giving fertilizers, we have to apply the water regularly up to 30 days, 1 month. Rest up to, afterwards the rest starts, and it may extends on the soil type up to 45 to 60 days. Then 20 days before start of new bahar, digging of soil under the canopy up to 6-9 inches, that is root pruning, or the start of bahar we can start, the pruning and everything. So this is root pruning. You can see the root pruning. It is not a regular practice actually. 2 years or after 3 years, we should do this root pruning. It gives a very better results for canopy also, the development of canopy also. The unwanted roots or the affected roots, we are removing this in this root pruning, and that will definitely help for your better canopy. Thank you. I have given my number here also for the farmers actually particularly. Because many farmers from Karnataka also, they are in contact with me. They used to talk in Kannada, but I used to talk in Hindi. But somehow I am getting the message, and I am trying to advise them. So this is my number. If somebody wants to contact, he can contact me. So thank you very much for the organizers, for the organizing committee, and the listeners. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your elaborate presentation. Now I think the topic is open for questions from the participants.
Sir?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, Dr. Koti, sir, please.
Sir, it is an excellent topic, nicely covered. And of course, I am new to this crop as a physiologist. Otherwise, a very good and excellent information has been provided here for all the audience and also farmers. Sir, you told that this is a xerophytic plant.
Yes. Hello, you can sir? Continue, sir.
Yes, you told it is a xerophytic plant. Is it only because of cuticle and as well as uncle stomata?
Pardon?
You told this is a xerophytic plant. Is it because of a sunken stomata as well as the thick cuticle present on the leaves?
No, it is because of the adaptive strategies that plant have. Unique adaptive strategies like sunken stomata, less number of stomata, then cuticle on the leaves, then fatty acids on the leaves. So these are number of, then thorny nature. So these are number of adaptive strategies of this plant. That actually, that's why it becomes a xerophyte.
Okay, sir. And sir, next one more, please, sir.
Yes, sir.
And the diseases are more for this plant. Though it is xerophytic plant, there are more diseases I have heard. And it's affected by diseases, fungal and bacterial blight and all those things. Is it because of giving more water and nutrients to this plant?
Yes, sir. That is one of the reasons. The exogenous use of fertilizers and exogenous use of water is the major reason for bacterial blight also.
Yes, sir.
For all the fungal diseases also. In that, what I was showing you the plant in that my industrial project, we actually were not spraying anything in that plot. But my colleagues, they were forcing me to have one spray at least for 15 days. And that's why we are spraying actually. I was avoiding that 15 day spray also. But that is also not needed.
Sir, the only pruning is enough to maintain the female to male flowers. No growth regulators or nothing is used.
No, not necessary. In pomegranate actually use of growth regulator is not necessary. Only rhizosphere maintenance and the canopy management. That is light pruning. That is important.
Water shoots are nothing but hydroshoots.
Sir, if the canopy is minimum, then we have to maintain the water shoots. And if the canopy is dense, then we have to remove the water shoots. It depends on the situation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, ek question mera hai.
Boliye.
सर ये मेरा ये क्वेश्चन है कि पोमग्रेनेट में जो अपन कैनोपी मैनेजमेंट में जो आपने सिंगल ट्रेनिंग सिस्टम और एक मल्टीपल ट्रेनिंग सिस्टम बताया बताया उसमें से सर कौन सा जो ट्रेनिंग सिस्टम है जो कि हमारी मैक्सिमम फ्रूट प्रोडक्शन यील्ड को और साथ ही साथ में क्वालिटेटिव फ्रूट प्रोडक्शन को एंश्योर कर सकता है
नहीं उसमें क्या है सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट है लीफ एरिया हेलो प्रशांत शिंदे जी म्यूट के लिए आपका तो अभिषेक डॉक्टर अभिषेक एक्चुअली द मेन थिंग इज टू हैव ए मैक्सिमम लीफ एरिया ऑन द इन द कैनोपी एंड इन मल्टी स्टेम द लीफ एरिया इज मोर एज कंपेयर टू द सिंगल स्टेम सो इंस्टेड ऑफ सिंगल स्टेम वी शुड गो फॉर मल्टी स्टेम And another thing is there, the problems are there in pomegranate, like soil problems are there, the nematodes problems are there. And in this case, suppose a stem is affected with some of the problem, then if you maintain single stem system, your whole plant will go. But in multi-stem system, we can uproot your single stem, one stem, and you can maintain the rest of the stems, and you can take the yield. So that is advantage in multi-stem.
Sir, I have one question for you, sir. Sir, this is Devasis, sir.
Since morning, you are asking the questions.
Yes, sir. I'm a very good learner. Okay.
Yes, welcome.
Yes, sir. Sir, you have mentioned about that sex of flower is determined by the pruning. You have said that light pruning is encourages the female flower production. But I want to know that how the light pruning and heavy pruning are maintaining the sex of a flower. Like how this heavy pruning is going for the male flower production and the light pruning is done for the female flower production.
Right.
Like flowering, sex of flower is quietly controlled by the hormonal aspect or the gene expressions. Yes. But how can we cultural practices means maintaining all this thing.
Yes, you might have heard about the fruit bud differentiation. So yes, for fruit bud differentiation in pomegranate, that requires maximum carbohydrates and lower quantity of nitrogen, CN ratio. More C should be there and less nitrogen should be there. If this ratio is there in between 70 to 30, 70 C and 30 N, then you will get maximum female flowers. But if the ratio is reversed, 30% carbohydrates and 70% nitrogen, then you will get only male flowers or shoots. So though it is a genetical phenomena, but still the canopy management gives a very best results in this particular induction of flowering. So that's why if you go for heavy pruning, you are removing the fruiting area, fruiting canes also. And instead, if you go for light pruning, you are maintaining the fruiting cane, where you will fruit bud differentiation, everything will be occur.
Okay, one more question, sir. Regarding different bahar system, cracking is a major problem in the pomegranate. So I would like to know that in which bahar system the cracking is the minimum with respect to anything, sir.
No, cracking is not a big problem in our area particularly. It has some problems in Rajasthan. or some cold area, right, like Himachal or everything, Jammu also. In our area, that is not the major issue. But still, the cracking wind, the cracking, if you see the thing of the cracking, you know, fruit cracking, you will see that whenever there is a fluctuation in the soil temperature, then and then you will get the cracking. So your regular irrigation, you might have heard about my application of water. I was applying the water regularly on Monday and Thursday. The duration hour I was maintaining between two irrigations. The intensity I was maintaining only 30 minutes. So if you maintain the intensity of the irrigation, you maintain the distance between the two irrigations, you will not get the cracking. But there are fluctuations in the irrigations in the farmer's field. And because of the fluctuation in the irrigation, you will get the soil temperatures differs. And because of the soil temperature differs in the soil temperature, you will get the cracking.
So can I conclude it that, sir, in the Mrig Bahar, Braha, that diurnal variation is quite high, then the cracking will be more in that Mrig Bahar system?
Cracking is in our area, cracking is more in Hastabar, not in Murugabar or Ambiabar. It may come in Hastabar, but to a very less extent. That's not the problem.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Mohammadullah Samadi.
Sir, मेरा एक question है. हमारे होम गार्डनिंग में एक पोमेग्रेनेट वाइन है और ये एरिया जो है समर उसकी समर बहुत ड्राई है यानी कि बारिश नहीं होता और उसके 10 साल हो गए हैं कि उसको कोई कैनोपी मैनेजमेंट नहीं हुआ है तो क्या हम कर सकते हैं कि इसके बाद उसका कैनोपी मैनेजमेंट और रूट मैनेजमेंट कर सकते हैं।
ये कैनोपी मैनेजमेंट कैसा है, जैसा अगर बचपन में हमने ठीक से संस्कार नहीं लगाए, बाद में 10 साल के बाद में हमें लगा कि भाई संस्कार लगाना चाहिए बच्चे को, तो हम लगा सकते हैं, वैसे ही है, आप लगा सकते हैं उसमें, नो प्रॉब्लम.
थैंक यू सर.
ओके, डॉक्टर सुपे, नाइस प्रेजेंटेशन एंड यू हैव रिलेटेड योर कैनोपी मैनेजमेंट विद so many other production technology aspects, especially, you know, irrigation. It's nice. I have one general question because you are a practical man. You said it, drip irrigation always, you know, perennial crops, later stage, most of the time we say that, you know, ring method so that water distribution all around the plant can make the root system very strong. So you said it is the drippers should be away from the canopy, right? The beginning, the canopy, you know, it is very small and you may have to change the drippers later. That is my doubt. Can you recommend that to the farmers? The later stage, they have to change.
Initially, when we plant the new plantation, at that time, we used to put those both the drippers near the canopy, near the stem, about 3 inches or 4 inches from the away from the main stem. But as soon as the crop starts growing, after two three months, we used to keep move the laterals away from the stem and underneath the canopy at the edge of the canopy, right. Not outside the canopy. It is always at the edge of the canopy. Yeah. So this is a continuous process, and in that particular trial, what I saw that up to 16 months, I was doing this business to maintain the distance between the lateral and the stem. But after 16 months, you can see the rhizosphere development and the root system development. So it was a very excellent. Many scientists, many even politicians, then bureaucrats, they have appreciated that irrigation system.
Two lines actually, that is no, four places you have got, so that the root development is there in all the four directions. That seems.
In pomegranate, it's a shallow rooted crop. Yeah. That's why two directions are sufficient. But in perennial crops, like where the taproot system is there, then we have to go for ring system or likewise, in citrus or in mango.
Thank you, Doctor. You have given a very detailed information. Dr. Praveen, just...
Yes, sir. Sir, thank you very much for such an elaborate explanation about the canopy management and its the flower regulation in case of pomegranate. It's a dollar earning crop, definitely. And as you mentioned, many farmers in Karnataka are also taking your help, sir. We look forward for such continued interaction with you from Karnataka side, as well as the participants who are from across the country. They wish you to interact with you. Thank you very much for sharing your mobile number. I request all the participants to note it down so that you can ask any question with respect to pomegranate problems with Dr. Supe. With his vast experience, he can give you the solutions. Thank you very much, sir, for accepting our request and giving this elaborate lecture. On behalf of University of Horticulture Sciences, Bagalkot, and College of Horticulture, Bidar, we wholeheartedly thank you and look forward for further interactions with you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
For our participant information, kind information, tomorrow we have two lectures, morning session. One is canopy management in Gawa under high density planting system. Speaker Dr. Praveen Jogalekar, 10 to 11 p.m. And second lecture, that plant architecture management in cashew. That is Speaker Dr. Dinagar Adiga. So 11 to 12, sir. Morning session. Again, we have the afternoon session, two lectures. One is plant dynamic in under high density planting system in mango and guava. And second lecture is the dynamic of the disease incidence and its management under the high density planting system in mango and guava. So this, I want to share the information to all the participants. We will have started at tomorrow at 10 a.m. morning session. Please, I request all the participants to join. Tomorrow session, and also thanks to all the participants who are actively participated from the morning to till the time closing ceremony today's session. Thank you, one and all.
We are closing session.
Thank you so much, sir.